I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
This is it. The big fight is here. Mayweather McGregor. I'm talking with Bernardo Osuna, one of the biggest experts on boxing. He is with ESPN. First of all, Bernardo, Mayweather McGregor, the fight's here. That's it. What do you say? You've interviewed both of them. You've covered every boxing superstar. What's going on with this fight? Break it down.
I mean, all I can tell you is we're going to be in for an interesting week. You know, no matter what happens, there's not going to be a dull moment. But it's upon us, and I don't think anything's changed since we first started talking about this fight. When you think about, you know, Mayweather, he's the same guy that we've seen make great fighters look ordinary inside the ring, and I just don't see how Conor McGregor changes that in his first professional boxing match. I mean, if Conor McGregor turns out to be way better than what we've seen in his sparring sessions, in his training sessions, then he's pulled off the biggest con in not only boxing history, but in sports history.
He fooled us, you're saying, if he wins this fight and he looks phenomenal.
Yeah, I mean, if what he's done in the gym and all the stuff he's done turns out to be a ruse and this guy's really just an amazing boxer, then, I mean, he would have failed. I mean, he would have faked everybody out. But, I mean, he's still got to do it against one of the top fighters pound for pound. I was looking at the statistics, and according to CompuBox, I mean, you look at Manny Pacquiao, and he wasn't even able to land triple-digit punches in 12 rounds against Floyd Mayweather. What makes us think that Conor McGregor has a chance? I mean, it's really a tribute to Conor's ability to sell a fight, to sell himself, and to make so many people believe that he's capable, because the odds, you know, really had a huge, he's had a huge impact on the odds, to the point where now Vegas odds makers are like, man, we could take a bath on this fight. But, you know, Vegas never loses.
Have you, I'm sure you've been in sports for many, many years. Have you covered like World Cup and Olympics? Have you had a chance?
Yeah, I was lucky enough to cover the Rio Olympics, and I've covered two World Cups, France in 98 and the South Africa World Cup in 2010. So I've been at the highest levels of competition.
Let me pan around for a second, show people. This is just the media room alone, one location for the media room. And this definitely does not look like a regular fight. This reminds me of an Olympic-style coverage. Can you relate to that? Tell me, even the security walking in with the chip and a barcode.
Yeah, it's pretty legit, man. So usually you get, you know, just a lanyard with a, you know, a temporary credential for the week. And then, you know, the day before the fight, you get a legitimate credential with your picture and stuff. This time we got, you know, wristbands with a microchip in it. You know, you walk in, they're like, no, you can't go through that door. You got to go in through here. Put your chip. I mean, next thing you know, it'll be retina.
As well.
Exactly. Yeah. So yeah, when you leave, you got to do the same thing. It's pretty cool. I mean, by this point at a World Cup or at an Olympics, I mean, this place would be packed, which I think is the only thing that really surprises me. But the events aren't happening here. They're happening down the way at the T-Mobile Arena.
Maybe so, everybody's set up there.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see how that goes. And I think as a fight week progresses, by weigh-in time, it's going to be one of the craziest experiences we've ever seen, you know, reminiscent of Mayweather Pacquiao and probably even bigger than that.
What does Mayweather need to do to win? What does Conor need to do to win?
Let's go with Conor first. He needs to surprise the world. He needs to shock the world, because if Conor McGregor is to really pull this off, his awkward style is going to be the only way to do it. You know, all those, you know, noodle arms and all that stuff that he did. I mean, he's going to have to be able to pull that off inside the ring and just be awkward, use his southpaw stance to throw Floyd Mayweather off. And he's got to do it early, because one thing about Floyd Mayweather is once he figures you out two, three rounds in, he's got plan B, C, D, E, E, all the letters to the alphabet compared to your plans A and B. And that guy's a genius in the ring. So if Conor doesn't strike early, he's not going to strike at all. For Floyd Mayweather, he's got to be himself. I mean, he's made a living based on defense and on making guys miss and on making them pay when they miss. That counter right hand against the southpaw especially is going to be ridiculous in this fight. But this whole I'm going to go get him stuff, I don't see that happening, because why would a man who cares about two things more than anything, that O at the end of his record and the zeros at the end of his paycheck, risk everything he's done, his legacy against Conor McGregor. Conor McGregor. He's going to go out and he's going to do what he always does. And you may be disappointed, but buyer beware. This is Floyd Mayweather, the best defensive fighter of his generation. Manny Pacquiao connected less than 100 punches against him. Most fighters connect less than 19% of their punches against Floyd. It's no coincidence. This guy knows what he's doing inside the ring.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Secback. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Secback.